Hi there, welcome to my new tutorial. My name is André Kröker from Dagubi. In this tutorial I would like to show you how to create this snake logo. Okay, I start with the head of the snake. Please choose the ellipse tool with black fill color and none stroke and create a new oval. With the direct selection tool, move this point here and deform it so, and this point so, left point and this right point. Okay, next go to the pen tool and choose add anchor point tool. Now add here a point and here. Now move this point so and now please press the Alt key and click on this handle and deform it so. Okay, next add new points, 3 points. Now with the direct selection tool, take this point and move it so. Now hold the Alt key and drag this handle and this handle. So next I create the tongue, create a rectangle, so now go to Objects, Path and click on Add Anchor Points. Next select these 2 points and convert it to Smooth. Now move this point down and this point up, and this point move it to the right. Okay, next deform it a little bit so. Okay, and so now go to Effects and click on Arc by Warp. Maybe 14%. Okay, and go again to Warp and click on Flag. Then click on Apply New Effect. So that's okay. Next, we need to place this song here. But before, go to Objects and click on Expand Appearance. Now rotate the tongue, scale it smaller. Now select these 2 shapes, go to Pathfinder and click on Unit. So I'll make the head a little bit smaller. Okay. So next step is to create the body of the snake. Go to the add anchor point tool, choose them and add new points here and here. Take this point and move it down here and deform it so by this handle. Press please the Alt key and drag it. So okay. So next we need to create this shield. Choose this pen tool and now create some points. Click here, here, here and here. Change the color to orange and move this layer down. So now select these two points and click on horizontal line left. Now select these two points and make it the same. Okay. So now select this point and this point and convert it to smooth. With the direct selection tool you can deform it so, and at this point please hold the Alt key and you can move this handle so and press the Shift key and you make this line vertical. Move this point up. Now change this point so. Okay, now select this shape. Now we need to reflect this shape, but before we do that, go to View and enable the Smart Guides. Okay, now choose the Reflect tool and click on this anchor point by holding the Alt key. The axis is vertical and click on copy. So now we have two shapes. Select both shapes, go to Pathfinder and click on Unit. Now you can deform this shape, make it a little bit smaller. So okay. So next we need a second shape like this and select the shape, go to Objects, Path and choose offset path. Set it to offset 20 points and click OK. So the next step, I'm going to apply a gradient to this shield. I start with this shape and apply a gradient, this black and white. Change the color to orange like this. Okay, and the black to dark brown. More red. change the type to radial. With the gradient tool we can change this gradient. So okay, now select this shape and with the eyedropper tool click on this gradient and deform it. Okay, now take this layer, make a copy and move it up and set the stroke to the gradient white and black and non-fill and set it to 6 points. And flip the color. Okay, now go to the snake layer and add a new anchor point here and move it down. Please go to view and disable the smart guides. Add a new point here. At a new point here. So now go to the color of this shape and apply a white stroke color. Three points and go to the stroke panel and change the align stroke to align stroke to outside. And the corner click on round join. So 2 points is better. Okay, now we need to add this eye, create this eye, lock all these layers, now create new ellipse. With white fill and non-stroke. Select this left and right point and convert it to corner. And with the scale tool, select by holding the control key these 2 points and now scale. Scale it so Okay, form it a little bit. Sorry. So now go to Effects, Warp, and click on Flag. Rotate it. Oh, sorry. Before you rotate it, go to Object and click on Expand Appearance. Okay, that's good. Now we need to create this eye. Create a new ellipse. And now with the Add Anchor Point tool, create new points here and here. And move the center point. So. Deform it. So please hold the Alt key and you can drag this handle. So now move this eye up and place it here. You can rotate it a little bit. Make it bigger. Select both shapes and rotate it a little bit. Okay. So go to this shield and apply a stroke color. Choose this dark brown. Set it to a 6 point and on the stroke panel click on the line stroke to outside. Okay. So now create this highlight. Make a copy from this layer and move it up. Change the color non-stroke and fill. Please choose this white black color. Now change the gradient. So. And go to this transparency panel and change the mode to screen. Set the opacity to 66. Now create an oval with the ellipse tool and move it so. Next, select these two layers, these two objects, go to Pathfinder and click on minus front. Change the opacity to 50%. And the gradient set it like this. Okay, so now select this and scale it smaller Okay, now create this shadow. Choose the ellipse tool and create a new oval. Okay, apply this black and white gradient and change the type to radial. Please flip the color, reverse, and scale it so and so. So next I'm going to make some corrections. For example, create here new points and convert this point to corner and move this point. Okay. Now I'm done. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.